3D Holly Leaves and Bells on Glasses Acrylic Nailer Tutorial by Hotpinkzebrapolish.
Hi guys, in today's video I'm going to be showing you how I added the holly and the little bells to these red glasses for Christmas. This is actually my second pair of Christmas glasses, so I will put a link to the other ones in the description box below. Those ones are Grinchy, so if you like the Grinch, definitely check those out. They're pretty awesome. I'm in love with them. So I'll be showing you how I did this. These glasses are from Goggles4U, which is a different one of those online websites. They're a little bit less expensive, but they also don't come with quite as much, and they seem like they're lighter weight. So you have to kind of balance the pros and the cons, as with anything. So I hope you guys like this video, and don't forget to click subscribe to see all my future videos as well.
So to start with, these glasses are from Goggles4U, and this is another online glasses store. That same thing, you can put in your prescription, really super easy and surprisingly accurate. And so this store I found was a little bit less expensive, but they don't come with as much, so you know, you kind of have to balance what you think. But as far as the actual glasses go, I'm just as happy as anything else. So on a nail form backing, I'm going to start sculpting out my holly leaves. So I took and I placed down two relatively large beads of a nice Christmassy green acrylic, and I'm going to start shaping them into my leaves after they set up for just a second so that they will hold their shape. Just pull those out and then just sort of push them in to give them that nice scalloped edge of the holly leaves. And then add a line down the center. The line down the center is less for actual detail that you'll see in the end of the design, but more as a glitter reservoir, which you will see what I mean in a moment. I don't know that it's necessarily necessary to do that. Necessarily necessary. But if you want, that's an easy thing to do that I think does add a little bit. So just create your two little leaves there. And then after you have them sculpted, wait until the first one starts to turn matte before you continue. So there's my two leaves. Now, don't mind the fact that I ended up getting rid of one and starting a different one. I didn't wait long enough with my first leaf, so that's why I had to scrap it and make a new one. But it's the same process, so you know, it's the same kind of leaf. So after you pick it up, place it on the frames, wrapping it around one of the lenses, which makes more of a difference on the lower one. So just kind of tuck that little end of the leaf in, just like that. Leave a space in the corner of the frames for where your bells are going to be. But then take a bead of some green glitter acrylic and apply that over the leaf, focusing it in that glitter reservoir so it's the glitteriest in the center and kind of fades the glitter out. Like I said, it's not necessary that you do that little glitter reservoir, but it does kind of make it look a little bit more deep because it gives you a little bit more of the darker green glitter in the center of the leaf and then just sort of fans it out some. After you have that done, I would highly recommend taking some just plain clear acrylic and applying that on the underside of your leaves to give them some more strength. So just flip your glasses over, grab a bead of clear acrylic, and just add it underneath that. That'll fill in any gaps that may be between the glasses and the leaf and make it so that they're not going to just pop off on you, which I doubt that they would, but you know, a little extra security never hurts. Plus, it'll give those more delicate areas of the leaf a bit more strength, which is always good because you don't want to break anything. And if you're like me, you drop stuff all the time, and dropping glasses is nothing surprising, so you want it to be nice and strong so you don't bust them. And then I'm going to take and I'm going to grab three little red bells and I'm going to glue them onto my glasses. So I'm going to take some nail glue, place that down, attach my first bell, hold it there for just a moment. That nail glue sets up so quick that hopefully it won't take you too long. Whenever I want my nail glue to set quickly, it seems to take an eternity, and whenever I place something down incorrectly and I want to just move it or pop it off so I can redo it, it is like cement. And I don't know what it is. I clearly have nail glue problems, but it just seems like the substance is always working against me. But hold your bells in place so that you've got a nice little trio in the corner of your glasses. And it shouldn't take too long, like I said, for that glue to hold up. After you have the glue that's just a temporary hold, I would take some clear acrylic and fill in the gaps around the bottom or the base of the bells so that it does hold them down a bit more securely. The downfall is that they don't make that little tinkling sound. They make more of a thunking sound. I don't know if that's the word, but the sound of the bells is definitely altered when you add the clear acrylic. So that's up to you if you want to just risk using just the glue. I mean, you can. They may not ever fall off, but you know, up to you, depending on what sound you're going for. If you don't want your bells to be loud, definitely go ahead and add that little bit of clear acrylic because it'll silence, well, not silence them, but it'll quiet them some. Then with white paint, I'm going to add a little filigree pattern going down the center of my leaves. I didn't want my leaves to be overly, obviously they're a leaf, they're leaf shaped and green, but I wanted them to be a bit more, I don't know, artsy looking, I suppose. So I added this really nice, simple little filigree pattern going down the leaf just to give it a bit more something to look at and a bit more, I don't know, a little bit more interesting. So just with white, obviously you could do whatever color you want. I wanted it to be white, red, and green just to keep it. Otherwise, you could use a gold. These glasses do have some gold accents on them, so gold would be appropriate as well, but I didn't think it would show up as much. So depending on how much you want the little pattern to show up, you can decide what kind of color you want to use. So just add that. I did not worry about making my two patterns the same. In fact, they were not the same or even close to the same. They were similar and complementary, but I didn't bother making them identical. If you like, you can, but I figured it'd be a bit more interesting if they were their own little personalities. So then apply some gel sealer over the top of the leaves to make sure that they are nice and shiny, and that's going to make that green glitter that's over the leaf really, really sparkle and just kind of catch the light and look so nice. So I hope you guys like this as much as I do, and please let me know who you think wears these glasses better, me or Melody. That was such a fun picture to take, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!